Let a of x equal the integral of f of t from 1 to x, where f of t is graphed below. We want to find a of 8 and a prime of 8. Notice for a of 8, we'd substitute 8 for x, which would give us the definite integral of f of t from 1 to 8. We can determine the value of a definite integral by determining the area bounded by the function in the x-axis over the given interval. But if the area is above the x-axis, we have to view the area as a positive value. If the area is below the x-axis, we have to view the area as a negative value. So let's begin by shading the area bounded by the function in the x-axis over the interval from 1 to 8. Notice how we do have area above the x-axis and below the x-axis. Next, we'll find the area of each region. Let's go ahead and call this a sub 1, and we'll call this a sub 2. We can use geometric formulas to find these areas, but I think we can also just count the squares here. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 full squares and 2 half squares. So a sub 1 would be 6 square units. Now for a sub 2, notice how we have 1 full square, and these two pieces make up another full square, giving us an area of 2 square units. Notice how we could also view this as a right triangle with a base of 2 and a height of 1. Either way, the area would be positive 2. But again, because this area is above the x-axis, we'd have to view this as a positive value. And because this area is below the x-axis, we need to view this as a negative value. So the integral of f of t from 1 to 8 would be equal to positive 6, and then plus a negative 2, or just minus 2, giving us a value of 4. Next, we're asked to find a prime of 8. Before we determine a prime of 8, though, let's find a prime of x, which would be the derivative of this integral. Let's go and do this on the next slide. So a prime of x would be equal to the derivative with respect to x of the integral from 1 to x of f of t. Well, this should remind us of the second fundamental theorem of calculus, where if we want to find the derivative of this integral from a to x, we can substitute x for t, giving us f of x. So applying this to find a prime of x, again, we'll substitute x for t, giving us f of x. So if a prime of x equals f of x, then a prime of 8 is equal to f of 8. So going back to the previous slide, we'll now interpret the graph to determine the value of f of 8. So we're trying to find the function output when the input is 8. Well, here's where x equals 8, and here's the point on the graph when x equals 8. Notice how the y value or function value at this point is negative 1, and therefore f of 8 equals negative 1, or f prime of 8 equals negative 1. I hope you found this helpful.